Hello, we're Paul and Emily Turner. We're from Turnview Farm Honey. We're located approximately 2 hours northeast of here in the small hamlet of Waverly, Ontario.
Our honeybees are doing very well. I'm very pleased with how they did this summer. Our hives produce well over 100 pounds each of honey per hive, so that was a lot of honey. Because of our management practices that we've introduced over the last few years, we feel that our honeybees have increased in their vitality. A few years ago, I started feeding essential oils to my bees, and I feel that's played a big part in how healthy they are nowadays. And also, I got into doing queen rearing, where I produced my own queens to head up the beehives. So, by producing my own queens, I have genetics that are compatible to our climate at Waverly.
Raw honey versus grocery store honey that I buy. We get asked this a lot. We market our honey also at a farmer's market in Barrie. So this is a very common question. So really just the short answer is that raw honey is unfiltered honey. There's no high pressure filtering. There's no high heat applied to our extracting process and our processing of honey. So that's really the two main things, is the no pressure filtering and no high heat applied. And so therefore, by not applying those two things, you're still keeping the goodness of honey in honey. So you're keeping all of the enzymes that are in honey, the good enzymes that are in honey, all of the good antimicrobials that are in honey as well. So because those are the good bits of honey. So by applying high heats and high pressure filtering, you're getting rid of a lot of the goodness that's actually in honey.
On a sunny day, I'll plan out my day and I'll know which bee yards need to be visited, what work needs to be done. I'll plan ahead and I'll make sure I have the equipment necessary to do that work at that yard. So a lot of the time it's just management, where you're inspecting a hive to see how they're doing, whether they need more space, maybe they need another honey box put on them, or more brood space, or perhaps there's some other management issues that need to be dealt with. So there's always lots to do. And of course, bottling honey to sell is a big part of it too. We always have to be bottling honey ahead of time for our customers. We sell honey directly from our farm. We have a self-serve honey stand at our farm where people can come in and purchase honey right off the picnic table, so to speak. And it's an honor system, and they put the money in the box and away they go again. Yeah, smokers, they do not harm the bees. Smoking the hive is the necessary part of beekeeping when you're going around visiting hives. Honeybees in the wild, if they smell smoke in the air, it's believed that it will cause a prehistoric instinct to kick in, and that they'll think, well, there's a fire in the bush, we might have to leave soon, so we better fill our bellies up with honey. And that's what they'll do. The bees that are in the hive will go and start gorging on honey. Of course, that reduces the number of bees that are going to come out the door and visit with me. The other theory is that it helps to mask the pheromones that are released by the bees when they sense danger. And my opening up a hive is danger in their eyes. So when you give them the smoke, that masks the pheromone, and then the alarm signal doesn't go through the hive, and it helps to calm the bees. So the main thing with smoke is to keep the bees calm so that we can work with them. Yeah, so our beekeeping year starts in the fall. And we harvest honey starting usually in the middle of August, and then we go forward for about the next month harvesting honey. We only harvest surplus honey from the hives, and this year we averaged well over 100 pounds per hive of surplus honey per beehive. So on 200 hives, that adds up to a lot of honey. But the honey that's left behind, that's what the bees eat during the winter time. And if a beehive going into winter is a little on the light side, in other words, they don't have enough of their own food, then I give them sugar syrup to help top them up in the fall. That way they won't starve to death over the winter. If you don't do that and the hive dies, well, you've lost the hive. So for a few pounds of sugar syrup, you might save the hive, and then you've got them for another year. We wrap the beehives through the winter months in black tar paper. And the black tar paper, of course, it's just the same as wearing a black jacket in the fall. In the winter, when the sun shines, you can feel the heat in the fabric on your back. So it's the same thing for a tar paper on a beehive. It warms the hive up. We wrap the hives and we insulate the under the roofs of the hives. It's just the same as you do have in your home or where you live. There's insulation in the attic to keep your house warm because heat rises. So if you don't have insulation in the roof, the heat goes out through the roof.
I get stung all the time. So, Paul in particular, he really has no effect from the bee stings at all. So he's often in a t-shirt working with the bees, depending on what we're doing with them. Myself, I use the entire suit because I do swell up and react to bee stings, so I don't like that very much at all. So I do have to protect myself more. But the biggest thing is to be proactive with your protective wear. I mean, it's critical to wear a veil in particular. You want to avoid getting stung in the chest up, especially the head area, very sensitive there. So really, a veil is extremely important to wear and protect your eyes and everything else. So a sting in the eye could lead to blindness, for example. So very important to wear the protective gear. That's the number one prevention.
The thing I enjoy the most about bees is just working with them. I enjoy a nice summer day, you know, with a warm breeze and the sun shining. And I can go to the bee yards in my t-shirt and put my veil on and my smoker and with my hive tool and just work with the bees. It's a pleasant way to spend your day. And you're working with nature and you're working with animals. And I enjoy that.
And I enjoy it. I'm a nurse, and so I really enjoy the connection with nature and also working with Paul because we work together on this. It's just our time together. It's our common focus, love that, you know. And it's so I find it's really almost like a therapeutic type of thing, you know, with a total departure from what I do in my career is to do this, Paul. So it's great on so many levels.